Us is Pop 309. I'm Dr. Paul Chima, and I'm taking it. It's titled Research Methodology 1. And the following are my details, my office hours, the email, phone number, office hours 10 to 4. That is when you'll be seeing me. The course description. This course is an introductory background to the conduct of social and organizational research generally, and public administration in specific terms. The course examines conceptual issues necessary for carrying out POP 309, which is the project. The course focuses on the following areas. One is the nature and significance of research in public administration. Second one is the basic concept in research. After the basic concept in research, we are going to look at the selection of research areas and how to choose a topic in research. When we are done with that, then we'll move to how to review literature in research. And after we are done with the review of literature in research, we are going to examine the meaning, types, and functions of research designs. When we are done with that, we now have an overview of how to collect data in research. We call that one method of data collection. And after that, we are going to look at research proposal and report writing. And when we are done with that, then we are through for the semester. So research methodology is a semester course, and it is 2-credit unit course. It is available to all learners at both regular and distance learning and continuing education. We are going into the course proper. The course, research methodology, is a course that is very, very sensitive and very important to every student of public administration. Of course, in real life situation, there are so many ways of finding solutions to problems. And one of the ways of providing answers to problems in real life situation is through research. Research is an attempt to provide solutions to novel problems. So in this section, this study section, we are going to examine the meaning of research. We'll look at the significance of research, look at the characteristics of research, and finally, we'll look at the basic types of research we have in research methodology. At the end of this course, you should be able to discuss, students should be able to discuss the nature and significance of research method in public administration. They should be able to identify and discuss the basic concept in research methodology. They should be able to select or choose a topic in research. They should be able to carry out literature. They should be able to know how to review literature. The student should also be able to examine the meaning, types, and functions of research design. They should also be able to identify and discuss the method of data collection and analysis. And finally, they should be able to prepare a research proposal and write their reports. Now, study section one is on the nature and significance of research. First of all, we'll look at the meaning of research. What is research? Research is nothing but a systematic way of providing solution to an identified problem. The whole essence of research is to provide solution to identified problem. It means that if there is no problem, there is no research. What from the above definition, we could arrive at the following characteristics of research. Number one, For an activity to be called a research, it must be systematic in nature. And what do we mean by that? The procedure must be in a sequence. It must be in a logical sequence, stage by stage, in order to arrive at the solution to the problem. And number two, it must be valid and verifiable. Any activity to be regarded as research must be valid and verifiable. What do we mean by that? Whatsoever solution we identify or provide to a problem must be replicated elsewhere. It must be rigorous. To be rigorous means it must be relevant and justifiable. And any activity to be called research must also have the ability of creating new knowledge. When an activity is not able to create a new knowledge, then it is not research. And not just creating the new knowledge, but the new knowledge must be, it must also verify existing knowledge. And it should find solutions to questions or to problems. So an activity that possesses these characteristics are referred to as research. Every activity that possesses these characteristics are referred to as research. Then, what are the importance of research method? There are so many importance of research methodology. One of them is the formulation and re-evaluation of existing theory. All the theories we are studying in public administration, like theory of motivation, theory of leadership, they are outcome of research. And if you want to reevaluate an existing theory, let's say Max Weber's theory, or let's say Abraham Maslow's theory of motivation, if you want to reevaluate to know its current, to know whether it is still current and relevant to the existing body of knowledge, it is through research. Then number two, every research must provide useful information. Research is an activity that generates useful information to the society. Research is also very important because it helps in the societal development. There is no society across the globe that will develop without research. Research is the stepping stone to the development of every society. And research is also very important because it is the foundation of knowledge and wisdom. If you want to generate knowledge, you must carry out research. And then the rightful application of that knowledge in order to solve problems in the society is the wisdom aspect of it. So research is very, very important because it is the foundation of knowledge. And finally, research provides solutions for societal development or societal problems. When a problem is identified in a society, we must carry out research, follow certain procedures to gather information about that problem in order to procure solution to such problem. We have the various type of research. Research are various types, but we categorize them according to purpose, according to method, and according to approach. We are going to take them one after the other. We look at according to the purpose of the study. If you are carrying out a research according to the purpose, want to carry it out according to the purpose of the research, then we have these types of research. One is the applied or basic research. Applied or basic research is the type of research that helps in generation of new knowledge. If your research is targeted at generating new knowledge, the type of research you are doing at that point in time is called basic or applied research. So it answers questions like why, answers questions like what, and so on and so forth. Then we have number two under the purpose is the exploratory research or ex post facto research. This type of research is used to discover existing but hidden reality. Existing but hidden reality. It means that the reality, the issues are already in existence, but they are hidden. So the best way of bringing out the hidden reality is by exploration, or using what we call the ex post facto research. Then we have, under the purpose, we have the descriptive research or the survey research. This type of research is done when we have to do a sample of the population. We carry out, we have a population of the study, and sample, take certain quantity out of the population in order to study them by using maybe simple random sampling techniques to administer your instrument to the sampled size of the population. So you don't study all the population, rather we look at a portion of the population, which we call the sample size, then administer our instrument and get results, do our analysis and arrive at our findings. Then under that, also according to the purpose, we also have evaluation research or program evaluation. This type of research is done to, is a systematic way of making assessment of resources expended on achieving the research goal, such as the money, what are those resources? Money, time, energies, and so on. So when you want to evaluate those resources expended to carry out the research, we normally use what we call evaluation research or program evaluation. Then we have, according to the method of research, that is the second type of category we have under the types of research. If you are looking at it according to the method of research, we have what we call analytic research. What does analytic research mean? It employs critical thinking. It employs fact check and evaluation in order to invent new ideas. So if you are trying to invent new idea, you use what we call analytic research. And under the method also, we have what we call the survey research. The survey research uses quantitative method to obtain data from the respondents. What are those quantitative methods? Like we use what we call regression, use ANOVA, using t-test, and so on and so forth, to analyze your data in order to arrive at a solution to a problem. So in doing that, before we do the analysis, we administer our instrument, usually the questionnaire, to the respondent, and after that we gather our data and do our analysis. Then we have experimental research method. The experimental research method is used to establish relationship between variables. It is used to establish relationship between variables, maybe dependent or independent variable. If you are trying to establish relationship between variables, then you use what we call experimental research. From there, we'll be able to know whether the relationship is significant or it is not significant. Then finally, according to the approach utilized, we also have the following types of research. One, we have the quantitative research. When we are talking about quantitative research, we are talking about the type of research that use mathematical and statistical techniques to collect data, to collect and analyze data. So when we are doing a research that involves the use of some statistical tools like ANOVA, regression, T-text, Z-text, and so on and so forth, we are into quantitative research. And the second one, according to the approach, is the qualitative approach. This one does not use statistical instrument. It does not use statistical treatment on the data collected. And that is why we say statistical treatment is not needed in this type of approach. What we do is to use content analysis. We look at the data on ground, usually the secondary data. When we look at the secondary data, use content analysis in order to arrive at our findings in the study. And finally, we have what we call the mixed method approach, if we are going according to the purpose. The mixed method approach combines both the element of quantitative and qualitative research. So when you are using the elements, some of the characteristics of quantitative research combined with that of the qualitative research, you are into what we call mixed methods approach of research, which means use quantitative technique and use qualitative technique. Use some statistical tools in this place. It's mixed method because it goes beyond using one method. You use statistical tools and use non-statistical tools like interview and so on and so forth. You have the student have the following materials that they can consult, references to consult. In summary, we have been able to define what is research. We have been able to identify the characteristics of research, examine the importance of research, and finally, we've been able to explain in detail the basic types of research. Thank you so much.